Hunter Stever. I would never know that you have two broken elbows right now. You look pretty happy, my friend. Walk me through the emotions of this weekend.
Coming back from Big Tens, you know, arms were kind of struggling, but, you know, I was positive all week, you know. Steph kept saying they're getting better, doing everything we could. I just wanted to get out here, do everything I could for the team, you know, hopefully slip in, maybe All-American, do whatever I could. Didn't happen for me, but, you know, I was right there with my teammate, Debbie, every chance of waiting, you know, helping him out, you know, talking to Kenny, getting ready, Kenny ready, tell him, give him my piece of advice, you know. That's awesome.
Winning that title, I like that hat. It looks good on you.
Yeah, thank you.
But what happens here moving forward with you? You got another year left, but you got to have two elbow surgeries.
Yeah, I get in like a week I get my first elbow surgery, Tommy John surgery. So then a couple weeks later I get my left one, and then the recovery time's not too bad. I'll be back in like 6 months, so September, October, I should be back on the mat full time.
41, 49, 57, 65. What weight do you go next year?
I'm probably going to be a 49. I mean, as soon as I started, like, actually making 49, I didn't get above 55. And I was low. I'm still, like, I stopped checking my weight, like, yesterday, and I was, like, 53. I mean, I don't get much bigger than 55. I mean, I'll get bigger now, but when I started cutting, it was so easy.
You know, looking at you, you're such a selfless kid, man. And I've known you since you're a little guy. And you're always happy-go-lucky. You know, right now, very disappointing weekend for you personally, but I think you're happier for your brother and the team. You're such a selfless guy. Where's that come from?
I mean, you know, I know I did all I could. I mean, it's a weird feeling getting out there and knowing that you can do a lot of moves to these kids, and then you try and you're like, you just can't. Like, it's like they cut off my arms and they put pool floaties on. So,
pool float, like a noodle arm.
Like a noodle arm, like the little noodles. So, It's a weird feeling, but, you know, I've known it. I've had my right one done for like 6 months, and then my left one just happened in the Penn State match in January. So, I mean, I've known it for a while, but, you know, I just hope I can go out there and hopefully score some points.
How happy are you for Logan Stever right now?
I'm so happy. I'm mostly happy that I don't have to worry about him anymore. Even though I know he's going to do really good and mostly like a pin the kid, I get so, like, gutted it off. Feel sick. This is his last match. Like, I don't care that his last match is that I gotta wait all that time.
I've seen him commit felonious assault on you no less than 1,000 times. He's made you what you are. How do you feel about you not having him next year potentially?
It's gonna suck, but he's gonna be in the room with RTC. I went around that very much for a little bit. I mean, but you know, it's always good having him. Now we got Nate. We have Nate Bowen, Snyder. They really are the reasons why I came back. Every day I sat on the bike, biking, you know, trying my hardest, you know, sweat, get a good workout in, but I couldn't do anything. And watching these guys just go at it, go hard, just nonstop, in and out, every single day, multiple times. You know, you want to be a part of that. They make you want to be a part of that.
Being one of the toughest humans on the planet, I say that about you all. You and Roy Nelson. You know who, have you ever Googled him?
You tell me the story.
Dude, the guy is like a human punching bag and he can dish it out too. But like, your threshold for pain, why would you put yourself through this? It was hard to watch, man.
I kind of had to tell people like my pain. Like, I just told them like a little bit about it. Like, especially like my girlfriend, like she had always asked me. And I was like, I just told her like, you know, it's not that bad. And in reality, you know, it's pretty bad. But I mean, I figured, you know, tell myself, fake it till you make it.
Listen, not many people have as a sunny a disposition as you do right now. It's always great to talk to you. You got anything else for me?
No. Go Bucks, man.
All right. Hey, congratulations on the national title.
Thank you.
And giving all your heart and soul, man.
Thank you.